And welcome back to the News at 10. So that. And welcome back to the News at 10. South Africans are being ripped off by funeral operators. That's the view of the United Funeral Association of South Africa. The organization says the industry is facing a grave crisis and it wants government to regulate. The UFASA boss, Johan Rousseau, says the industry is flooded with what he calls unscrupulous operators. Mr. Rousseau claims funeral homes are burying people without death certificates. He says some charge as much as 3,000 rands for registering a body. This is despite the fact that this service is offered freely by the government. Mr. Rousseau also says undertakers market their services to pensioners by targeting them at pension pay points. He says in some instances, they allegedly pay preachers a 500 rand commission to refer bodies to them. The clergy is often the first group of people called by families immediately after a death. Now, Johan Rousseau is the founder of the United Funeral Association of South Africa. And you're here to tell us a little bit more.
Thank you so much.
All right, now when a person dies in a hospital, for instance, you notify their next of kin, the body gets taken to most probably a state mortuary, death certificates issued. At what point then does the corruption occur?
The corruption occurs in various aspects. It starts at the immediate point of death. Either in the hospital, nursing staff, the counselors, hospital staff, ambulances, CIDs, clergymen, SAPM, mortuary and government officials, or SAPS officials, that's where it really starts. But certain parlors, not all, make the suggestion of referrals with monetary rewards.
All right, you say even within the SAPS, that's government circles.
Yes, but we must understand that the problem does not only arise within government structures. Because unfortunately, we have to admit that the industry makes these kind of offers towards the government officials as well.
Now, okay, we've outlined some of the problems in our introduction to this interview. But you're suggesting that government must regulate. How can government fix these problems?
Well, government needs to apply and endorse and enforce the act, the regulation. We will assist and advise government on how to do that. But the funeral industry did not disclose the discrepancies of this industry towards government and the complexity thereof. I believe that our government is so democratic that they would have done something long ago if they knew exactly what the problem was.
Now, if government is to regulate, they're going to do things like introduce codes of good practice, as they've done on the question of BEE, for instance. But that would mean meeting with a whole series of stakeholders. That starts with the citizen, the actual individual who is subject to death, and that's every South African, so 45 million people. Then you'd have to deal with short-term insurers. Then you'd have to deal with the health department, the hospitals, probably social development, the people who are issuing out some of the payments and concessions to poorer families, stock fills that are involved in financing these people. There's a lot of people in the loop. How does government get around that?
Well, I think government needs to look at the two core issues, which is first the health regulation, which affects our communities. Death certificates does not state HIV/AIDS status, which is affecting the staff, together with especially African people that dress the remains prior to funerals, and they don't know what is happening. And then secondly, which is very crucial, is death certificates. And people do not certify people dead, which has effect on financial services. It has effect on our justice system. For example, a person could be committing a murder, which could be changed in culpable homicide because the person is not certified dead at the point of death.
Does the entire industry think that this is a huge problem? You've just had a conference where you've met with the clergy, undertakers. Do you think this is a huge, huge problem?
Well, I could definitely say that the people that we've interacted with, including the industry role players, agrees that it is a massive problem, but they all agree that government needs to enforce it, and that was the concern, is how it is being done, because there is control measures, but it needs to be enforced, and we do not know whether the ability is there to, from the industry's perspective, to...
The ability is there. I know of some pretty reputable undertakers. I can think of a few. I won't advertise their names on national TV, but people who were known to bury struggle activists for free. If a poor family comes, they will not charge them the prices that they do. And then by the same breath, they will have those lavish funerals for the people who want the limousines and whatever it is the people want. There are some reputable undertakers. What's your sense about how they get involved?
Well, most definitely, yes. We agree that there's very reputable funeral parlors out there. And I could mention names, but I also said during our interviews and the conference that we're not prepared to do that. But we could say that we mustn't put everyone under the umbrella of being unscrupulous, because they are rendering an essential service to our communities.
Okay, thank you very much, Johan Rousseau, the founder of the United Funeral Association of South Africa. Thanks for coming through to the
news. Thank you very much, and thank you for
at 10. After the break, Muriel looks at the empowerment deals in which Brett Kebble was involved and whether or not they can be sustained. It's after the break, don't you go away.